It's the latest report that's been issued by the Swiss forensic team that have been examining the remains of Yasser Arafat that were exhumed from his gravesite back in November 2012. They've got some quite unusual, interesting results and conclusions that they've arrived at following an in-depth sort of forensic analysis of those tissue samples, bone samples, and samples from the personal effects of Yasser Arafat, the late former Palestinian president, who died in, of course, 2004. What the report says is that they've identified what they call unexpectedly high levels of radioactive polonium inside the tissue samples and the personal effects that they've examined, which they say, in their words, moderately supports the theory that he may have been poisoned. Obviously, this is a very controversial issue. A lot of Palestinians believe that Israel is behind the death of Yasser Arafat back in 2004. The Israelis, of course, categorically denying that. On his medical records, it says that Yasser Arafat died of a stroke resulting from a blood disorder. The report is not meant to be conclusive, and indeed the Swiss forensic scientists that wrote it said very carefully that there were a number of critical issues that brought the results, the conclusions, into question. The first one saying that the results were based on limited samples. They only got, you know, a few shreds, a few threads of hair, a few layers of tissue from Yasser Arafat, on which they had to base their samples. They would have preferred, they said in the report, for an autopsy to have been done back at the time of the death. They also indicated that 8 years since the passing of Yasser Arafat and when the tissue samples were taken meant that the actual remnants of polonium-210, that radioactive substance, were very low indeed. It has a half-life. It halves in its presence every 138 days, so there was not much there. They also talk about the chain of custody of some of the samples, particularly the personal effects they're talking about, is not entirely clear. So they raise the possibility that they could have been contaminated by a third party, and not actually been contaminated by Yasser Arafat himself. So not conclusive results, but results that the forensic team say moderately support that poisoning theory. Already the widow of Yasser Arafat, Suha Arafat, has gone out and said that this is a real crime. She's quoted by the Reuters news agency saying that this is evidence of a political assassination. Here's what she says: "This has confirmed all of our doubts. It's now scientifically proven that Yasser Arafat didn't die a natural death." Again, the Israelis have denied any connection to this. The Palestinians as well have not actually pointed the finger of blame at the Israelis at this point. They're saying that the outcome of this result requires the start of a criminal investigation.